The following tape diagram describes the relationship between the amount of red paint and the amount of blue paint needed in order to make plummy purple paint mix. So they show us here that for every 4 parts red, you need 3 parts blue. Or you could say that the ratio of red to blue is 4:3, or that the ratio of blue to red is 3:4. Now they ask us, suppose the x-axis represents the number of red paint cans and the y-axis represents the number of blue paint cans. Let's scroll down a little bit. So the x-axis is the number of red, the y-axis is the number of blue. First, find 2 sets of corresponding values of x and y and graph them. Then determine whether the relationship is proportional. So we know if we have 4 parts red, we need 3 parts blue. So let me graph that. So if we have four parts red, that's that axis, we're going to have 3 parts blue. And what if we had 8 parts red? If we had 8 parts red, well, that's 2 groups of 4, then we're going to need 2 groups of 3 for the blue. Once again, the ratio of blue to red is always 3:4. Here, literally, you have 3 blues and 4 reds, so you have a 3:4 ratio. Here, you have 6 parts blue, 8 parts red. The ratio of 6:8 is the same as 3:4. Now, the question is this proportional? So you have a proportional relationship if the ratio between these 2 variables is always the same. And we already said the ratio between them is always the same. The ratio of blue to red is always going to be 3:4. Another sign that this is a proportional relationship is that it's a line. And not only is it a line, but it's a line that goes through the origin. And that makes sense. If I have 0 red, well, if I'm going to have 3/4 of that blue, well, 3/4 times 0 is still going to be 0. So this is a proportional relationship. We could check our answer. Yes, it is. And let me explain that last point in a little bit more detail. So as we said, the ratio, and I'm going to do this in the right colors, of blue to, I don't have an exact red, I'll do this orange, that's close enough. The ratio of blue to red is always going to be equal to 3:4. And so if you multiply both sides by the number of red, you could say that the amount you have in blue is always going to be 3/4 the amount that you have in red. And you can also verify this. When R is 4, if you have a 4 here, 3/4 of 4 is 3. Blue is 3. And so if R is a 0, if this is really proportional, then this is also going to be 0. A proportional relationship will always go through the origin. If you don't go through the origin, it's not a proportional relationship. If it's not linear, it's not a proportional relationship.